is education? Education is a continuous and a creative process. Its aim is to develop the capacities which are latent in human nature and to coordinate their expression for the enrichment and progress of society by equipping children with material, human and divine knowledge. What is true education? True education? Religious capacities which are hidden in the nature of a child. It is not filling the bucket. It is not the garbage collection center or an information collector center. You put the information and child vomits in the examination copy, he gets the mark and he has got knowledge. No, 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 no. This is not knowledge. It is bringing out something which is hidden. Edison brought the bulb from his mind. It was hidden. Graham Bell brought the concept of telephone. So all these things that we saw all around, camera, TV, car, you know, aeroplane, ship or train or metro or whatever we see, or watch or anything, all this has come from the mind of man. The man is a mind rich in gems of inestimable value. Education can alone cause it to reveal its treasure and enable mankind to benefit therefrom. The man is a mind. All the capacities are hidden in the nature of man. The true education releases those capacities, develops analytical abilities, confidence in oneself, willpower and goal-setting competencies, instills the vision that will enable him to become a self-motivated agent of social transformation. Dear friends, a child has three classrooms. Classroom number one is the home. Classroom number two is the school or the university. Classroom number three is the society. Now, these are the three classrooms of a child. I take home. Home. In home, the family that prays together stays together. You know, the mother, the father, the brother and sister, they're all praying together in this home. This is the 21st century home. In this 21st century, we want to make a home like this, where Gita is also recited. Quran is also there, Bible is also there, Guru Granth Sahib is also there. This home is blessed by God and by all the manifestations of God, all the divine educators, or you may call them the messengers of God. They are the messengers. They brought the messages of God. These are the messages of one God. All these books are the message of one God. All these books are for each one of us. Everybody on this earth must know about these teachings. All these teachings have come from one Allah, one God. They are all from one. And then classroom number two, or the school or university, it is the secondary source of empowerment. What is a school? A school or university is the lighthouse of society to provide meaningful education, spiritual direction, guidance, leadership to students, their parents and the society in general. Well, education must go on the classes, but at the same time, prayer is also very, very important. Teach our children both education as well as prayer. Knowledge, wisdom, spiritual perception and eloquent speech, universal values, global understanding, service to the world and excellence in all things. We need to give these qualities to our children, and let us make every child both good and smart. Child and youth, both good and smart. Not only smart, today's education making children smart. What we need to make them both good and smart. Good means godly. That means godly qualities, which God has sent these qualities in Bhagavad Gita, Tripitak, Bible, Quran, Guru Granth Sahib, Kitab Ekdas, Kitab Ejavishta. So all these teachings. So make him good and smart. Good means with good qualities, and good qualities are given in these holy books. God has sent these. What are the good qualities for us? And then be smart. Then be smart. And if the child is both good and smart, he will become a gift of God to mankind. He will become a pride of the human race. And he will become a potential light of the world. So dear friends, I again come to that. Material, human and divine, all things are necessary. Now, I tell you this. If a child, the bulb is connected to the powerhouse, light comes to the bulb. But if it is disconnected, there will be no light in this bulb. There are, you know, God, this is the kingdom of God. All the holy books have come from one God. If the child is connected to the entire kingdom of God. A child will become rational, wise, godly, good, total quality person, TQP, and total quality manager, TQM, like a divine angel, a good human being, is a blessing for human society. But if this wire is broken, the child becomes only one. He becomes a Hindu or a Muslim or a Christian or a Buddhist or Shia or Sunni or Protestant or Catholic or Nirankari or Kali. What can happen? He can become irrational. He can become unwise. He can become ungodly. He can become bad. He can become totally misguided person. He can become TMP and he can become totally misguided manager, TMM. He can become like an animal. A bad human being is a curse for human society. Totally unworthy and unacceptable to society. I am Hindu. I am a Sikh. Why don't we realize that we are God is one? All these books have come from one God. All the revealed books of God have been revealed by one God from age to age for the education and benefit of all mankind. These are the books for all mankind. Quran is not only for the Muslims. Quran is for the whole of humanity. The teachings of Quran or teachings of Bhagavad Gita or teachings of Tripitak or Guru Granth Sahib or Bible or Tripitak, all these or Kitab Ekdas or Kitab Ekdas, these are all the teachings of one God. They are for the entire creation. They have come from age to age. All these teachings are unerring and also they are the collected wisdom. All the revealed books of God are unerring and collected wisdom that are sent by one God as required from age to age to open the mental locks of mankind and to cure the maladies of the age. You know, the maladies of the age, how can they be finished? It is only through the God. God sent his messages and with this message, the people change their lives and these messages are translated into hundreds and hundreds of languages. Is spread all over the world. So these are the messages, not only Bible is not only for the Christians. Bhagavad Gita is not only for the Hindus. Unfortunate thing is, Hindus believe that Bhagavad Gita is for them. Muslims believe that Quran is for them. Christians believe that Bible is for them. How come God is so small? You are making God so small? God is omnipotent. He has created the sun and the moon and the sky. Is he so small to send a message only for a particular class of people? Will he send it? Do you think that God will be so partial? No, God is never partial. It is our misunderstanding. We have to clear our misunderstanding. We have to realize all these messages have come from one source. The source is one. And God is only one. When God created Adam and Eve, they were the first husband and wife God created. God decided to, he made this world, and then he decided that let there be some children. Children will sing song, dance, and this and that. I will be very happy. He realized. So he created husband and wife, Adam and Eve, and said to them, the first lesson that he gave to them was, every father or mother gives a lesson to the children. So the first lesson they gave us to Adam and Eve was, that was the lesson of religion. God told them that your religion will be to live in peace and unity. That is your religion only. And when your children come, you tell them my religion, that they should live in unity and peace. And tell your children, when they bear children, they should give the religion of God to their children, that that is the unity and peace, unity and peace, unity and peace. Year after year, all the ages, the religion has never changed. Since the day one when God created this earth, till today, or till eternity, till the sun and the moon and the sky and the, everything will remain, the religion of God will never change. It is eternal. God is eternal. God will never change. So his religion will never change. And he is the savior of all mankind. He is the creator of mankind. He sends his messages. from time to time, whenever we forget or any need arises. For example, one god thought of justice. He sent a message through Krishna that justice is needed. For the sake of justice, even if to punish my brother, punish him. Nyayarth, apne bandhu ko bhi dand dena dharma. This is a religion. If you have to punish even a brother, even a family member, punish him. It is not only for the judges. Judges do this. But it is for the common man that do justice. Every man, husband and wife, children, and all the, everywhere there should be justice. So this was the message, universal message. Unfortunately, Hindu thinks this for them. How come God will send this message of justice to just for Hindus? This is ignorance. That ignorance has to be removed because school is the lighthouse of society to provide meaningful education, spiritual direction, guidance, leadership to students, their parents, and the society in general. So this is the message. Buddha sent the message of equality. Upper caste, lower caste. These are the Brahmins, they are very high caste. They are the Kshatriyas, they are lower than the Brahmins. They are the Baniyas, they are lower than the Kshatriyas. And they are the Shudras, untouchables, the scheduled caste, they are the lowest. This division is man-made. Manu Maharaj, a Maharshi Manu, he was a man. He committed a mistake. People believed him, oh, he is a great saint. So they believed and they started believing in the caste system. The society was divided into, you know, four parts. This unfortunate. The Buddha came and cleared it. God sent his message that all are creations of one God. Nobody is upper caste, nobody is lower caste. This whole humanity has been created by one God. God has never created anybody, you know, upper or lower caste. They are all our creation. Bhagavad, the Ramayana, you know, Ramayana is a, not the revealed work of God. It is the word of Tulsidasji, who wrote on the teachings of Ram. Yeah, most of it is very good, according to Bhagavad Gita and Tripitaka and Bible or Quran or Guru Granth Sahib. Everything is based on the teachings of God. But there is one teaching which is wrong. Dhol gamar shudra pashunari ye sab taadan ke adhikari. Those who are illiterate, dhol gamar, shudra, those who are untouchables, scheduled caste, shudra, pashu, those who are animals, like cows or buffaloes or, you know, goat or, you know, all these, and the nari, that means the women, they are to be chastised. They should be kept in under control. This kind of division, God has never made no difference in man or women. No book teaches any difference, but you know, he is a saint. Saint, he has written everything according to the teachings of God. But then he has committed one mistake. Man can commit a mistake. Saints and seers can commit a mistake, but God never commits a mistake. All the revealed books of God, these are the revealed books of God. This is unrevealed. All the revealed books of God are unerring. And collected wisdom, what is the collected wisdom? Who collected the wisdom? Who has given this? Who has given it? God. He has collected the wisdom. From when? When the day one, when God created this earth, till the book was released by God, all the teachings were revealed. All the wisdom of the past is enshrined in Bhagavad Gita, up to 5,000 years. 2,500 years ago, this Tripitaka came. All the wisdom up to 2,500 years, since the day one, is available here. All the wisdom up to 2,000 years is here in the Bible. Since the day one, till the date this book was revealed by God to a manifestation of God. All the wisdom of the past, since the day one till 1,400 years ago, when this message appeared in the soul of Muhammad, that was whole, all wisdom is there. And then Guru Granth Sahib, all the wisdom of the past till 550 years ago is enshrined into this book. All the wisdom of the past has been enshrined 200 years ago, Kitab-e-Qasam, the Bahai book. All the wisdom is there. So all these wisdom, all these revealed books of God are unerring. If all the professors of the world, all the learned men of the world want to find out a mistake or add a comma or full stop, they cannot do it because these are unerring. And moreover, they are the collected wisdom. For whom? Who collected? God. For whom? For his creation. Why? Because he loves us out of his love. And what are these wisdom? They are from time to time, from according to the need of the society. All the revealed books of God are unerring and collected wisdom that are sent by one God as required from age to age. As required from age to age to open the mental locks of mankind and to cure the maladies of that age. For example, this Bhagavad Gita was revealed 5,000 years ago. There was a need for justice. And the king, and though just there were no courts, high court, supreme court, lower court, there were no chief justices, judges in those days, in olden days. Only the king or the emperor or the ruler was the chief justice. He was the chief justice, he was the judge, he was everything. And if anybody had any complaint against anybody, he will come to the darbar, that means a place where the king listens to the grievances. He will put his complaint and the king will ask the person who against whom the complaint has been made to call him. He was called.
May CMS fragrance fill the sky and his name endure forever and may its founders' ideals inspire to strive, to seek, to ever aspire. May we uphold the good and fair in all that we do and dare. At home, at school, at play, in actions of the day. Is a temple of learning where knowledge and wisdom rules, where we become the changes we dream of, our most beloved school. Our lessons are of peace and love, our anchor is of spirituality. Our greetings for all is Jagat. Our vision is of world unity. Unique in the annals of education, our founder is a one of a kind. We are the light of the world, and CMS, the hope of mankind. May CMS fragrance fill the sky, and its name endure forever and aye. May its founders' ideals inspire to strive, to seek, to ever aspire. May we uphold the good and fair in all that we do and dare. At home, at school, at play, in actions of the day. At home, at school, at play, distractions of the day.
Gradually, as the arts of life improved, the forests cleared, lesser natural regions fused into greater, advancements in science, technology, World Wide Web, and now the advent of artificial intelligence, it may perhaps be thought that with the continuance of this process, all mankind will be in the end unified. Man's oldest dream to establish one world state or world government with an established world parliament and world court of justice. If human civilization is not to go down in blind internecine conflicts since the bombing of Hiroshima and Nagasaki and the recent spread of international terrorism, global warming, stockpiling of weapons of mass destruction, fear of a third world war and nuclear holocaust, there must be a development of world planning for world federalism as enshrined in the ancient Indian wisdom of Vasudhaiva Kutumbakam, or earth is but one country and mankind its citizens. Behold, how good and how pleasant it is for brethren to dwell together in unity. Is it a tenable dream? Perhaps so. As for the past 6 decades now, Guinness World Records holder City Montessori School in Lucknow, India, founded by Dr. Jagdish Gandhi, who remains active as ever as the nerve center of his school community, has redesigned his school syllabus through the integration of education, religion, law, and justice to create world-minded and socially conscious citizens who would work for the welfare of humanity and its unity. Unity will bring divine civilization on earth, and to make it happen, CMS, the winner of the UNESCO Prize for Peace Education in 2002 through its curriculum of education for protection and security, since the turn of the century has been convening the international conferences of chief justices of the world that aims to unite the world for children through enforceable international law and effective global governance. CMS students and management have been fervently asking for a safe and secure world, especially for the 2.5 billion children of the world and generations yet to be born. A democratic world government based on establishing peace and solving environmental problems. And here is their appeal to the President of United States of America, Mr. Donald Trump. Team CMS received 370 dignitaries consisting of chief justices, judges, heads of states, speakers of parliaments, ambassadors, legal luminaries and world unity promoters from 71 countries who were graciously welcomed to participate in the 19th International Conference of Chief Justices of the World on Article 51 of the Constitution of India, headed by the convener of the conference, founder of City Montessori School, Dr. Jagdish Gandhi.
Nous ne cesserons pas de dire merci tel que notre président, chef de la délégation, vient de le dire. Et cette rencontre initiée par le Dr. Jagdish Gandhi.
Is an initiative with which they will not stop and they want to work more. And as Madam said, that this initiative taken by Mr. Gandhi to unite all the countries, to unite the world, and to get rid of all the conflicts, the international conflicts that are there between the worlds. And for this, he finds that all the people of the chief justices who have been invited here, they can really work towards peace and unity, and education is definitely the heart of all the development in this world. And he wants to thank Mr. Jagdish Gandhi and his wife, and he wants to thank the CMS, which the school which he considers is as the best school of the world, because they are talking about peace and world peace and
CMS
having a created better world at this level. He wants to thank CMS for this invitation.
Sir and ma'am, thank you so much for being with us here. It was an honor to have you here and to be able to speak to you.
Okay, thank you.
I have with me here right now Honorable Mr. Justice Beki Mafala, Chief Justice of Swaziland. Sir, we extend a very warm welcome to you here at the conference. Do tell us, how has your experience been here so far? Since the last 2 days you've been attending the conference, the discussions, what do you feel about it? How important do you think this kind of a conference is?
I'm coming here for the second time. I was here last year, I attended, and even this year I am attending. The theme this year focuses on children. It's a very important topic, because children are the future leaders of tomorrow. So far it is important that we nurture children, make them grow well, and also provide education for the children. It's an important conference for us. It's a conference that is aimed at creating world peace, and world peace can only be created by a united effort by all world community members. So the importance of children is that you have to teach them at an early age the importance of world peace, so that as they grow up, with the knowledge that world peace, as opposed to war, is important. It's an important conference for us all.
And so, talking about children and education, what do you feel, what kind of an education should be there in the 21st century? An education that would teach values of peace and brotherhood and unity to the children. Because CML, City Montessori School, it believes that the school is the lighthouse of the society, and it must concern itself, apart from academics, in the affairs of the world as well. So what do you feel, what kind of an education should be given?
Well, our attendance and presence today at the conference signifies our support for the values and goals of CMS. We fully believe and support the value and beliefs of CMS in respect of the total education of the children, that you are not only teaching the child the causes that will create his profession, but also teaching the children the global issues of the world, to understand how the world is made up and how the world can be made a better place.
What is the reason behind so much of unrest and so much of aggression and chaos in children, in the youth, and in the people of the world at large? What is the reason behind so much of animosity that people are having towards each other, countries, people, everybody?
We have terrorism that is sponsored by the world superpowers. It's a question of power. We have wars that is being created by the amassing of weapons of mass destruction. And in turn, the war causes the refugee problem. It causes also hunger, starvation, and death of many children around the globe. So you have the superpowers, the rich countries, producing weapons of mass destruction, which in turn are not good for the world community. So the purpose of the conference is to try and create an atmosphere of peace, of world peace, to discourage world countries from producing weapons of mass destruction.